Details of Hush Puppy's first appearance in court.
Updates on Hush Puppy matter. Guys, as you're watching this video, I'm gonna be like showing you most of the evidence, the write-ups that the FBI have presented against Hush Puppy. But the thing there is that if I want to read everything, we will sleep here. And in fact, I did not follow him to enjoy the money, so I will not be able to do that kind of work. But it's just gonna be a quick summary. And what would a quick summary be? Yeah, I'm gonna be like telling you guys some of the evidence that they were able to use to lay hold on him. And also, he also attempted, you know, also scamming English Premier League. I'm also be giving you update on that. And also how Woodbury, his colleague, also spoke with an FBI agent without even knowing. The charge sheet which gave an insight on some of the charges suspected Nigerian fraudster Hush Puppy is facing in the United States has surfaced the internet. Hush Puppy, who faces a statutory maximum sentence of 20 years in a U.S. federal prison if convicted, made his initial U.S. court appearance in the affidavit prepared by FBI Special Agent Andrew John Innocenti. The suspected Nigerian fraudster and his co-conspirators were accused of stealing over $16 million. The affidavit made in support of a criminal complaint and an arrest warrant for Hush Puppy also captured phone conversation between him and his co-conspirators after each business email compromise BEC fraud they allegedly perpetrated. They were also accused of attempting to dupe a Premier League club of 100 million euro. It also captured photos of Hush Puppy's luxurious lifestyle, which was alleged financed by proceeds of crimes he allegedly perpetrated. In a new release statement by the United States Attorney Office, Central District of California, embattled Nigerian socialite Raymond Olorunwa Abbas, better known as Ray Hush Puppy, who was extradited to the United States by the Dubai police earlier this week, is said to have conspired to launder hundreds of millions of dollars from the likes of a U.S. law firm, a foreign bank, and an English Premier League soccer club. Computer intrusions, fraudulent schemes including BES schemes and money laundering targeting victims around the world in schemes designed to steal hundreds of millions of dollars, according to the affidavit. Recall that Abbas was arrested last month by UAE law enforcement officials. FBI special agent earlier this week obtained custody of Abbas and brought him to the United States to face charge of conspiring to engage in money laundering that is alleged in a criminal complaint filed on June 25th by federal prosecutors in Los Angeles. According to an affidavit filed by the complaint, Abbas maintained social media accounts that frequently showed him in designer's clothes, wearing expensive watches, and posing in awe with luxury cars and chartered jets. The FBI investigation has revealed that Abbas financed this affluent lifestyle through crime and that he is one of the leaders of a transnational network that facilitates a computer hacker gaining unauthorized access to a business email account, blocking and redirecting communications to and or from that email account, and then using the compromised email account or a separate fraudulent email account to communicate with personnel from a victim company and to attempt to trick them into making an unauthorized wire transfer. BEC schemes are one of the most difficult cyber crimes we encounter, as they typically involve a coordinated group of con artists scattered around the world who have experience with computer hacking and exploiting the international financial system.
said United States attorney Nick Hannan. The case targets a key player in a large transnational conspiracy who was living an opulent lifestyle in another country while allegedly providing safe havens for stolen money around the world. As this case demonstrates, my office will continue to hold such criminal accountable no matter where they live. International boundaries, traditional financial system, and the digital sphere, said Jesse Baker, special agent in charge of the United States Secret Service Los Angeles field office. Technology has essentially erased geographic boundaries, leaving transnational criminal syndicates to believe that they are beyond the reach of law enforcement. The success in this case was the direct result of a trusted partnership between the Department of Justice and our federal law enforcement colleagues. This partnership helped dismantle a sophisticated organized crime group who prey upon unsuspecting businesses. It is thanks to this partnership that the American people can feel a bit more secure today. Woodbury was arrested last month in the United Arab Emirates, where he was living, according to a statement from the U.S. Attorney Office in Chicago. He was expelled from the country and into FBI custody and arrived in Chicago Thursday night. He appeared in court Friday morning to face a charge of conspiracy to commit wire fraud. The schemes resulted in attempts or actual losses to victims' companies in the tens of millions of dollars, including a Chicago-based company that was defrauded into sending wire transfer totaling $15.2 million. The complaint states, the complaint described several instances in which one or more unknown subjects gained unauthorized access to a U.S.-based company's email account and sent messages to unwitting employees claiming to be from the company or a known business contact. Olalekan Jacob Ponle, 29, popular on Instagram as Woodbury, who allegedly orchestrated an international cyber fraud scheme targeting several US-based companies, has been charged in US District Court in Chicago with conspiracy to commit wire fraud.
So this is a chat evidence between Woodbury and an FBI agent. So he was just chatting with the FBI agent without even knowing who he was actually chatting with. So guys, there are a whole lot of evidence to nail these guys, like so much. So they've been going to court. We don't know where the matter is gonna actually end. If they are convicted, they are gonna spend 20 years of their lives in prison. For Hush Puppy is already 38, and if he should spend 20 years in prison, then he should be 58. Oh my god, what a wasted life. Fast lane is never the best.